See, the question of peace in Jammu and Kashmir, or for that matter in the whole of India, is a whole of government approach. It involves the political sphere, it involves the local government and administration, it involves the security forces, of which the army also forms part of. So it is not as if it's just the army doing it. It is the whole nation which is together and which has to work together to bring about peace and tranquility. In this overall gamut, the role of the army is to bring down the levels of violence to an extent where the civil administration and the local security forces can then play the role that they have to play in the development of the region and of course of J&K. So that is where the army's role lies, that to work in sync with the local administration and all the other forces who are here. The ultimate aim, of course, being to bring down the levels of violence so that peace and development can take place. Well, I have been briefed by all the commanders on ground on the situation, both on the line of control as well as the hinterland. And I'm glad to say that all the parameters that we judge normalcy by have seen great improvement. There have been very few terrorist-initiated incidents. There have been hardly any cases of stone pelting, hardly any cases or nil cases of any IEDs in the recent past. So all these are indicators of a return to a sense of normalcy, and these are all indicators that the Awam also wants the same. And that is, I think, a very good thing that is happening. And in this context of a return to normalcy, we are from our side prepared, and we have taken all the necessary steps for the smooth conduct of the Amarnath Yatra. Of course, the decision to conduct the Yatra or not lies with the civil administration, but we are ready from our side.
Okay, last question, Gohar from ANI.
Sir, what's your message for the youth of Kashmir?
I think I just made a slight mention of it in the previous answer. I think after such a long time, we have reached a situation where peace and tranquility prevails, where people are able and in a position to pursue their dreams and their aspirations. So my message to not only the youth but to everyone would be that it is only if we have peace and tranquility can there be development. And only if there is development will we be able to all prosper together. And therefore we should shun this path of violence. It does not get you anywhere. You just have to see outside how the world has moved on, how India has moved on. And therefore embrace the future. And the world over, the future lies in shunning violence. And if we do that, it will only hasten the process of ushering a new era of development and prosperity in the state.